Next, can our makeover team make one viewer look 10 years younger in just 2 hours? We're putting them to the test right after the break. Oh, we've reached our final 2 hour live makeover, where one of three lucky viewers not only gets the makeover they've asked for, but also a chance to at a 9 day holiday in Thailand, courtesy of Kamuka Worldwide.
Yeah, now this week we're getting a new mum ready for a day at the races. Our viewer, Nicole, hasn't changed her look in nearly 15 years. And now, as a stay at home mum, she doesn't glam up much at all. Our makeover team decided it was time for this filly to frock up and hit trackside for a girl's day out. Let's take a look.
Hi Nicole.
Hey.
Come on in. Let's go. Come through.
I rode into the competition because I've had the same haircut since I was 15 years old. I'm now 28 and I'd only just colored my hair for the first time about 4 weeks ago, and I'm just so bored with my look. I'm just sick of it. I just needed a change. Just wanted to look nice. Now that I've got a baby, my outings include groceries, going to the gym. My ideal day out would just be to go out, get dressed up from head to toe, be pampered, just make myself look pretty and to feel pretty inside as well. To me, getting all glammed up would include wearing something beautiful, a beautiful dress, beautiful fabrics, some nice heels, and long, beautiful, sleeky hair, makeup, nice smoky eyes, and just looking beautiful.
Okay, so I've picked out a couple of wedges for you. These wedges are perfect because, unlike a stiletto, these aren't going to sink into the glass.
Okay, look comfortable too.
Yeah, they are, because really they're only that high.
Yes.
But actually they give you that height with the platform. Okay, this colour is beautiful and it really goes well with your skin and your hair. And the dress is stunning, but it's actually a little bit too short for the races.
Katie, I look at this and it washes her skin tone out.
Yes.
Even if you were to pull the hair back. So how do you feel in this?
Very ladylike.
Yeah?
To have a team work on me is fantastic because I only got my first eyeliner about 2 weeks ago. My hair's always been the same, and clothes, I'm really plain simple girl, just jeans and plain tops, and I'm always scared to step out my comfort zone with my wardrobe outfit.
I think the races is all about elegance, style,
yes.
Sophistication.
Yes.
So let's go down that road.
Okay.
Yeah?
My beauty regime includes waking up in the morning, feeding the baby, quickly washing my face, popping on some moisturiser, and that's about it.
A lot of mistakes that women make at the races is poorly blended makeup, too much, and really dark, heavy tanning. So this is all about being soft and glamorous at the same time. Ba-ba boom, that's old Hollywood glamour.
Va-va-voom! Will Nicole's trackside look be a va-va-voom winner? We're under starters' orders, but first we welcome our team of experts, makeup artist Philomena Natoli, hairstyling guru Troy Thompson, and fashion stylist Kate Waterhouse. All look at each other and smile. It makes it pretty
cool. Thank you. And without giving any giveaway glimpses away, our makeover candidate Nicole joining us as well in her, in her best bathrobe.
Don't turn around!
Philomena, we'll start with you. Okay, we're after a race day look, so what does that mean necessarily?
Well, with race day, because you're in broad daylight, you need to have really well blended and a really flawless finish. So what we're doing, we're still going to go natural, but as Calvin Klein says, to be natural, you need makeup. So we're going to make sure that we've got a really beautiful finish on Nicole.
It's like it takes a good half an hour to get a good natural look.
Yeah, at least.
I love it when you quote those famous philosophers. Troy, Nicole hadn't changed her hair much since she was a teenager. What are you hiding under that towel there?
Larry, Nicole has only ever done her hair colour once in 28 years. So, and I'm just changing the colour ever so slightly for her. Under the towel, or the turban we call it, this is a little bit more style for her.
Okay, because she had virgin hair before you got to it.
Yes,
right.
almost virgin. But, you know, as she says, she doesn't know what to do with her hair. So we just wanted to show her some easy ways of working out how to do it.
Okay,
and make yourself feel pretty.
And you've got a bit of length to work with there, which is always nice. Yeah. Kate, the rules for racing outfits.
Well, autumn racing is different to spring racing, so it's all about having the felt hat, having the nice stocking, closed-toe shoe, little gloves. It's all about looking elegant and ladylike.
Okay.
All righty, guys, you know the routine. You've got 2 hours now to get Nicole race day ready, and we will, of course, be checking on your progress throughout the morning. So good luck. Giddy up. As we say here on the morning show, giddy up.
Coming up later on the morning show, the truth about Gen Y. We reveal what they value the most, and the result might surprise you.
And maybe some more quotes from Calvin Klein too. But first, some tips about ideas about buying a home. Karen has the details.
Still to come, it's a race against the clock. So will our makeover team be able to transform this viewer in just 2 hours? Hair guru Troy Thompson hard at work there. This week we're getting new mum Nicole ready for the races. We'll see. Ooh, that looks interesting. We'll see Nicole's new look very soon.
A it doesn't ponytail. Look like he's really hard at work. It's just like
ponytail. Hair guru. I could do a ponytail. Yeah,
you could do a hair. Yes.
No. I could have given Nicole a ponytail.
Yes, but then we couldn't have. But then he'd be sitting here, spraying my hair.
Also,
I'm glad you're here. Also ahead.
But after the break, want to look 10 years younger in just 2 hours? Well, some expert advice from our makeover team in just a moment.
It is now time to check on the halfway progress of our two-hour makeover challenge. And back with us are makeup artist Philomena Natoli, hairstyling guru Troy Thompson, and fashion stylist Kate Waterhouse. Good morning, guys. Welcome back. Nicole is here too, but still under wraps there, Philomena. Nicole is mum to 11-month-old Christian. Never has time for makeup, okay? So you say you want to create a Hollywood style today?
That's right. So Nicole actually has a really classic face, so we're just giving her the right techniques and also showing her how to accentuate different features.
Okay, so this could be the inspiration you're drawing from?
Yes.
Yep. Maybe this sort of look is what you're going for.
Yeah, Angelina has accentuated her lip there.
Okay.
So.
All right, is that maybe the way we're heading down? Now, Troy, you didn't want to be bothered with hair flying around or hats dipping during race day excitement, right?
One of the worst things you see women at the races is halfway through the day, all their hair's falling out, the hat's falling down. Mm. So what we've done is we've actually added headline hair pieces today. Mm. So we're going to create a chignon style with a fabulous side part.
Okay, so this is sort of some of the inspiration you're
inspiration. See how it's sort of all up off the face? You can still wear a bow around the hair, but it's got that fabulous chignon feel.
I was going to say when I saw Nicole that the chignon style would work well for her.
Do you know what that is?
I've got no idea.
It's a fancy bun.
A bun. Okay, you spend like a whole bunch of time trackside. How do you stay stylish all day long?
Well, my biggest advice is not to drink too much, so stay on the water.
And if that doesn't work?
And she has a team of stylists looking after her.
No, but it's, you know, it's easy to keep your hair up and go to a professional to get it done, but really just don't take off those shoes. If they're too sore to begin with, don't wear them. Wear a flatter pair, but just keep it together the whole day. Okay. Nothing's worse than seeing the drunken girls walking down with their shoes in their hands. And
So this is what we should be aiming for, this sort of perfection.
Yes, definitely. That's old school glamour, and it's perfect for winter racing. You've got the felt hat, you're not too exposed on the arms.
Yeah.
It's just the ideal look for this winter. Yeah.
Super stylish, isn't it? What are you doing there? Oh, that's steam.
Giving it a steam.
Oh, wow.
The whole idea is also is that you can go from the races to dinner. Mm. As well, and you know, so many girls get it wrong all the time. So what we're trying to do is just show you how you can go from the races to dinner and it still looks stylish.
Sure, and depending on whether you won or not, whether it's KFC or a restaurant.
Yeah, that's right.
All right, guys, we'll see. We're just sort of finished posters in sight now, so good luck to you. We'll see you all very soon. Xinyang, it's also the name of my favourite Chinese restaurant, so it's good to see you.
He still didn't get it quite. Is that quite right?
Xinyang.
Is it?
That's Xinyang. Like,
what is it? Any word, right? It's French.
Oh, is it French? Xinyang.
Xinyang.
Oh, yeah, French. Rubbish.
Said, mean girl Lindsay Lohan gets in trouble with the law again.
Excuse me.
Excuse moi.
That was not French. That had way too much MSG in it to be French. You know. First, say goodbye to flat rate car insurance for good. Glenn has all the info. First, the results of our two-hour morning show makeover. Stand by for an incredible transformation, and that's right after the break.
And and it's nearly time for the big reveal of this week's Makeover series.
Currently a stay-at-home mum, our viewer Nicole wanted a new look for an outing with the girls. Our team has been going through the paces and prepping her for a glamorous day at the races. But before we see the results, Philomena, Troy and Kate are back with us, along with Nicole's husband Mark, who's nervously chewing gum like there's no tomorrow. Guys, you've had just 2 hours. You're pretty much, you know, you're happy with everything. We're about to see.
She's incredible.
Very. So chic.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, how are you feeling?
Oh, great, yeah, fantastic.
Yeah?
Oh, he's a bit nervous.
He's super cool. Okay, because you should see your wife, you know, at home with the bub.
Yeah.
And that's what motivated her to apply, right?
Yeah, that's right. And just to get that glamour look, which I'm sure these guys did a great job, so yeah, look forward to it.
Mark's in construction and he can't wait to see what they've constructed for him this morning. It's time for the big reveal. Nicole, come on out. Oh.
Wow, you look beautiful. The brief was a day at the races, and wow, you look absolutely stunning. How do you feel?
Very classy, very glamorous. Not normal, that's for sure. But I love it. It's beautiful. I love it.
Mark, buddy, you feel a little ripped off. This is for a day with the girls and not for a day with you.
Yeah, well, look, she's going to have to owe me one, so I'm happy as long as I get my day, so, yeah.
Have a look at the before and after shots. Look at this.
Okay, well, how do you feel, Nicole, when you see that before and after shot?
Doesn't look like me. It's beautiful. I love it. It's really gorgeous.
Okay, team, what do you think?
I think we've achieved what we set out to do, and I think it's all about sophistication. She looks so stylish. You know,
so glamorous.
Yeah, and I think it's all about daytime to evening. She can take off her gorgeous little hat. She still looks chic. She's got a gorgeous bag. She looks beautiful.
Nicole, can we just get you to turn around and so that your face... Because we need to see the hair here,
the chignon.
Troy. The chignon.
The chignon.
Yeah. Because you've used some hair pieces here, and I think that's really worth... Look at that.
Well, the best thing about it is that her hair only comes to about here. So these are actually four pieces added into her hair, and they're called a cube. Which you can still have at home. You pop a hot roller in them, and it's just a bend under with a bobby pin.
That's a great colour match.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah. Don't you think, Les?
Oh, I think that's one of the finest chin youngs I've ever seen. Nicole, would you have had the confidence to, you know, put all this together on your own?
No way at all. I've learnt so much from all of them, you know, like the makeup, the hair colour, like, because I haven't really coloured my hair before, and the dress, like, I usually wear black dresses. I don't ever wear anything colour or anything like that.
So okay. Your suit colour, you should be.
And the red lipstick, that's a bold move.
Oh,
that's quite game to do that, isn't it? Girls fine with no, that
very
on
soft.
Red lipstick.
Still, we've gone very minimal on the eye, very much like Angelina Jolie, and we've just really amped up the lips.
Yeah, all beautiful.
Right, good stuff.
We hope you had fun, Nicole.
Thank you, I have. It's been great.
I hope your little bub recognises you.
Thanks, Nicole, and thanks, Mark. And thank you, of course, to Philomena, Troy and Kate and to David Jones for providing the $500 outfit. Okay. Well, next week, we're going to check back with all our three makeover candidates and see how their transformation has sort of changed their lives. And, of course, the real test, whether they've managed to keep their new look.
And whether their children recognise them when they walk home. You'll also get your chance to vote for your favourite transformation. The winning candidate will win a holiday for two in Thailand, thanks to Kamuka Worldwide. Thank you, Kamuka. $300 worth of Kerr Starsay products and a $300 Samantha Wills jewellery voucher. Plus, doesn't end there, gifts from Roses Only and Hampers Only.
And finally, if you'd like more styling tips from Troy Thompson, you can catch 10 Years Younger in 10 Days. That's tonight on 7, right here at 9:30. Thank you, guys. Congratulations
Thanks, guys.
To you on the great job.
It's a good one tonight, too, isn't it, Troy?
Good
Okay. Head on the show.
Mark didn't tell his mates, he just said, just going out for smoker, boys. I'll be back in 10. Off you go, mate.